So welcome back to Electric Vehicles channel, my dear friends. I am Krishna Chaitanya Mandela, and today we came to New Delhi to support a new startup called Mazat Electric. And right now I am with the founder of the company, Mr. Akhil. I wonder, what is the inspiration for you to brought up such a wonderful designed electric bike?
So this is a custom designed electric bike. My passion for riding, my passion for exploring distances brought me to this. My technological background helped me with engineering this masterpiece which is in front of you right now. So I was in Chennai a couple of years back, and I started to explore riding on two wheels, and I started with the Activa. So when I went on a distance of around 300 kilometers from Chennai to Pondicherry and back, I realized there is a lack of comfort in that vehicle. And so you can't really go distance with that, the vehicles that are currently in the market. And I wanted to shift to the new technology because I am a very enthusiast about the new and latest technology. So I wanted to work in this EV segment. I started looking for the bikes that are in this segment that can offer me the utmost comfort and also give me the long distance option. So there was a lack of it. And similar thing I felt that my fellow riders who enjoy long distance riding and also are well versed with the technology, they might feel a gap of this thing in the technology that is currently in the market. So seeing my technology background and having a experience in electric vehicles domain, I planned that I will make this vehicle on myself, and I will pitch to the riding community and other riders who want to explore this passion of their riding and also conserve nature as a byproduct. They will be able to contribute a small significant contribution which will help aid a very clean environment for their coming generation. So that's how we came up with Mazat Electric.
When did it start?
So we started it in this year, January. So we built our first prototype by April 2021. Since it was a lockdown situation at that time, we couldn't do the test rides of that vehicle. But as soon as it ended, we did the test rides and we came up with improvements and our final design in this model that we have in front of us right now.
Okay, tell me one thing, Mr. Akhil. What makes your cruiser electric bike separates the existing cruiser bikes in the market?
So as of now, if we talk about the cruiser electric segment, we have very limited options. There's no company that has actually launched and delivered to a customer. And if you talk about the IC engine segment, it's about the change that the automotive market is bringing to, not only to companies but also to the consumers. See, we are talking about the latest technology, that is, EV is not something new, but the paradigm shift is important. So I want the customers, the consumers, to be part of this change and contribute their part in shifting to the EVs.
Okay. Now coming to your cruiser, what is the name you are looking for this bike?
So we have named it Mazat Electric.
The startup name is Mazat Electric and the bike name is also?
Yes, it's called a Mazat. Our first model is called Mazat.
Okay. And what is the innovation you put up in this electric bike?
So it has innovation in its battery pack. It's a custom engineered battery pack which offers you the longest range. This is on the hardware side. Also on the software side, we are building a complete AI system for the user which will aid in complete tour planning for the user. For example, you want to ride from here to a long distance, for example Rishikesh. You don't have to plan anything. You just have to sit on the bike, switch it, set your navigation and start riding. The complete planning part, charging part, the complete navigation part will be taken care of by our bike. So we are giving an end-to-end user experience to the user. That's how we are planning to shift the user requirements to meet his best experience.
And could you please give us a complete details about the technical specifications of this bike?
So this hardware that is with you right now, this offers a range of 300 kilometers, 300 to 350 kilometers. And it comes with a customized battery pack that offers you around, as I told, 300 kilometers. And it can be charged in less than 8 hours from 0 to 100%. And it can be charged up to 50% in less than 3 hours. It comes with a hub motor, which is offering you 10 kilowatt power, and it can give you an acceleration of up to 90 kilometers per hour in less than 6 seconds. This is the specification of the bike that you are seeing right now.
And what is the top speed for this?
The top speed that it gives is 120 kilometers per hour.
Okay. And may I know why you still using the hub motor on this bike?
The hub motor is because the hub motor gives you the power to go with that speed. Also, it gives you a space to pack in more batteries that gives you a long range, so that you don't have to face any range anxiety and your long distance touring becomes much more convenient.
You are not providing DC fast charging with this?
We are providing DC fast charging with this. Okay. You can charge it at any fast charger publicly available right now. Also, we will be installing our own charging stations at remote locations as well as on highways, so that you find a charging Buzzard electric charging station everywhere that you go. And yes,
you mentioned 300 to 350 kilometers of range.
Yes.
May I know the battery capacity for this?
The battery capacity that we are targeting is around 25 kilowatt hour.
25 kilowatt
hour? Yes.
In this space, is it possible?
It is possible. We are doing the engineering and we are doing the technology domain, research on technology domain. We have tied up with a couple of professors from colleges and we are working on optimizing the battery so that we can optimize the range.
Okay. And the battery pack, you said 25 kilowatt hour battery pack. Isn't it the overall cost of the electric bike will be a little expensive?
So yes, it will be expensive since 70% of the cost is of the electric battery. But it's the experience that we want to give to the customer, not only about the product, but about the software and hardware integration that will give an end-to-end experience to the consumer. Not only to the riding community, but also the people who want to explore the world on two wheels. It's for them. So price comes secondary for us. It's the first thing that we want to meet the customer experience to the full satisfaction.
So you mean to say you're targeting for the premium bike user?
Yeah, it is kind of for the premium bike users. It's not for the city bike. We are not targeting the city segment.
For example, people who love to do vlogs and all, they can have this kind of
bike. It's the perfect for them, so that they can enjoy the road, they can enjoy their vlog, instead of focusing on when they have to charge, focusing on when they have to find a suitable charging station and all. So it's the best blend for them.
What kind of steps or precautions you took while designing comfort for the rider? Have you taken any kind of precise decision making on this?
So on that, I will let you know that the best experience that one can tell us is the user. So we have done test rides on our first prototype. This is our second prototype. Currently, we have done around 20 test rides on this prototype that is in front of you right now. And more test rides are lined up in the coming month of January. So we are targeting around 100 test rides. So based on our feedback that we got on the first prototype and the feedback that we have got on the during the making of the second prototype, we have built the posture and the handling with respect to that feedback. So we have taken the user feedback to build a prototype that is best suited for the user.
Okay. And may I know the targeted price for this electric bike?
So we are targeting around 3.5 lakhs for this bike when we launch it.
Okay. And do you think you will get subsidies from the government?
Yes, since FAME 2 subsidy is applicable till 2023 and we are targeting a launch of 2022 mid. So yes, FAME subsidies will be applicable on our prototype, on our product as well.
So you mean to launch in next year?
2022 mid, we plan to launch.
Okay. And are you going to be accurate for the delivery dates? Are you going to delay the delivery dates like most of the companies?
So we are not committing, but this is our target.
So only that launch date, delivery dates you are not committing?
Yeah.
Okay. So you are confident the product is well designed and it is ready to go on the roads?
The product is well designed with respect to the hardware. This is the software part that we are still working on. We are awaiting the user feedback on that. So this hardware part is almost finalized with the specs. Yes, we have to do more R&D to fit in the desired battery pack that we want to fit. But on the software part also, we are working on it.
So moments ago, you mentioned you are testing up to 25 kilowatt hour lithium ion battery pack.
Yes.
But let me put a question for you. So you started almost not even a year still now.
Yes.
So still you are working on the battery pack optimization. Then on what basis a customer can believe on the battery pack, because you need to do a lot of R&D testing on the battery pack also. How many kilometers of testing you have done on the battery pack?
So right now, since we are limited to our campus only, which is JTU East campus, so we have not gone the distance to measure the range and all, since we are using a smaller battery pack for our prototype. But yeah, if the user wants to have a confidence, he is very welcome to take a test ride. And we will be communicating to the customer about our developments, about our research, so that he gains the confidence that yes, we are here, we are engineers, we are here to build the product that is best suited to their requirements.
So how many life cycles are you going to offer for the customer?
It will offer you around 3000 life cycles for the battery.
LFP battery, sir?
It's a lithium ion battery.
NMC?
NMC.
Okay.
So we have given a complete cruiser design to it, cruiser's position to it. So person shoulder will be in level with his arm, and he can sit back and relax and enjoy his ride. We are planning for a dashboard which will be in the front, which will give you a knowledge about the critical parameters of the bike. For example, the range, for example, the battery SOC, and the speed that you're going at. And the navigation features and the AI tools, everything will be integrated in the dashboard that will be at the tank, on the tank side. So it will tell you about the, it will guide you about the navigation, it will guide you about the nearest charging station, when to charge, where to charge. It will have a Bluetooth connectivity with your phone and it will interact with the cloud with the for the data. We'll have a mobile application which will also at the home, at the comfort of your home, you can set your navigation, you can plan for your tour, and you can set other critical parameters. It also has got auto monitoring system for your critical parameters of the bike. For example, if your pressure is less or more, you can easily get the information in this dashboard itself that you are planning to integrate.
Are you planning for a fixed battery or a detachable one?
It's a fixed battery.
Okay.
Completely fixed battery. If you want to charge it and all, directly you can plug it into our charging port, which is we have provided on the left hand side.
So that's the complete details about Mezart Electric. They came up with a cruiser electric bike, which is a premium in segment. And they are planning to give up to 300 to 350 kilometers of range on a single stretch, and that too with a top speed of 120 kilometers per hour. And it is mostly for the vlogging purpose, like for a long distance commuting. And they are touching up a new segment here in the electric vehicle, especially in the two wheeler market. So, and wishing all the best for the whole team of Mezart Electric, and personally thank you Mr. Akhil for the wonderful innovation.
Wonderful to have you, Mr. Krishna.
Yeah. For general information about electric vehicles, please to subscribe to electric vehicle channel, and for fast updates, please to follow our Facebook page, website and Telegram group.
Go green, go electric.